Oh, is it going YouTube? Most Sports Network back again today with another episode of the Ohio Bobcat Dynasty. Today we are taking on the University of Akron here from Infocision Stadium in Akron, Ohio. We're going to kick off and get right underway. Here's Isaiah Cox. He's going to return that out to roughly the 30-yard line, 29 yard return for Cox, and we are going to get right underway here. Here comes Nathan Rourke, Julian Ross, and the Ohio offense right away. Rourke going to keep on the first play of the day, and he's going to pick up about 15. This read option has been so dominant for Ohio so far this season. Hopefully that can keep up. Rourke going to scramble out now to the right. He loves to do that. Throw on the run. It's going to be a catch by Julian Ross, and he's going to pick up 10 on the season. Ross already almost at 500 rushing yards, looking to have an even better day today. Ross is going to take the handoff there and pick up 7. So now it is 2nd and 3. Rourke going to scramble out to the right. Looks like he's going to launch at the last possible second, and that's going to fall incomplete, and Rourke is down. So here comes Joe Mishler in the first time today. He's come in at other times in the season for Rourke to go down. And Mishler's going to pick up the first down and more. That's a 13-yard rush by Joe Mishler. Good stuff by the backup quarterback for Ohio. The backup running back, O'Shawn Allison, also in the backfield. Handoff to Allison, and he's going to pick up the first down. So now 2nd and 4 for the Bobcats. Nathan Rourke, thankfully, back in the game. So he's going to roll it to the right, the exact same play that got him hurt. He's looking for his man, can't find any, and he's going to step out of bounds to not take another unnecessary hit. So now 3rd and 6 for the Bobcats. Rourke going to drop back. He's going to throw, finds it open. Kevon, no. Kevon Harris drops the pass. So Ohio will have to send on the field goal unit. Here comes Louis Zervos. His kick is up, and it is good. So Ohio will take a 3-0 lead. Looking into the studio, Texas leading Oklahoma in the Red River Shootout for any of those interested in the score of that game. So we're going to take our first look at Akron and their quarterback, Cato Nelson, on offense. First play of the game, going to throw to Nate Stewart for 8 yards. Now Akron, man in motion in the backfield, Cato Nelson. Yelling to his line, going to hand off to Sands on that play. Deltron Sands, his first carry of the day, a very solid running back for Akron. He picks up 4 yards right there. Now Cato Nelson going to throw, finds Williams tackled behind the line. That's a 2-yard loss for Andre Williams. Akron has some talented receivers on this roster for sure. Cato Nelson going to drop back now. He's going to scan the field. He's going to get sacked and fumble. Cato Nelson able to recover the ball, but a 7-yard loss on that play, and Ohio will end up getting the ball back. Another handoff to Julian Ross on Ohio's next possession. He picks up 10 right away. Rourke going to drop back again now. He's going to roll out to his right like he likes to. Pick up by Isaiah Cox. Isaiah Cox going to make his way out to the Akron 40. Just 2 plays in Ohio. Already in business. Nathan Rourke going to drop back now. And they're going to find Cam Odom, the best receiver on this team. That's a 13-yard reception for Cameron. Ross in the backfield now. He's going to keep. He's going to make a move and pick up about 8 yards on that play. Ross, again, averaging like 7-8 yards a carry in this game so far. Nathan Rourke going to drop back now, scanning the field. He's going to roll it to the left. He has room. He's going to make the first down. That's 3 yards, just enough to get the first down right there for the Bobcats. Ross still in the backfield for Nathan Rourke. Ross going to keep. He's going to run up the middle into the end zone for the Bobcat touchdown. So that is a 10-point lead for Ohio right off the bat. So Cato Nelson and Akron need to respond. Deltron Sands in the backfield. He's going to get the handoff. He's going to hit to the 30, to the 40-yard line, to the 50. There goes Deltron Sands to the 30, to the 20, 10. Hudson can't make the tackle, and there goes Deltron Sand to the end zone for a 76-yard touchdown run. And that is how you respond to a 10-0 deficit. Deltron Sands breaks the NCAA record for longest run. Obviously not the real record, but what NCAA 14 has as the record, Deltron Sands breaks, and Ohio has to respond to that defensive collapse right there. So Nathan Rourke going to hand off to Julian Ross, a 7-yard rush for Ross. He's getting that every single time. Now Rourke alone in the backfield. He's going to drop back. He's going to scan the field. He's going to find Cam Odom. Cam Odom open with room, and he's going to fumble. Picked up by Connor. And that is something you cannot have happen if you're Ohio, moving down the field so easily. Cam Odom clearly fumbled that ball, and now Cato Nelson's going to take over again. Nelson going to drop back. He scans the field and finds Jeremiah Knight for a 15-yard reception. Now in the I formation, handoff to Deltron Sands. Sands stiff arms a man and picks up about 5. So now 2nd and 5 for the Zips. Man moving in the backfield. Cato Nelson going to drop back, scans the field, throws, finds Long. Daryl Long with a 14-yard reception, about a minute to go in the first quarter here today. Cato Nelson perfect so far, throwing the football. Little bit of motion, Nelson going to drop back, draw to Deltron Sands, and he's going to be tackled with only a gain of 3 right there. One more play before the quarter ends. Hand off to Deltron Sands. Good blocking by the Zips and gets an 8-yard rush. Now we go into the second quarter. Ohio leads Akron 10-7. A handoff now. Nope, he fakes it. He's going to throw to the end zone and finds Andre Williams. That's a 6-yard receiving touchdown. Cato Nelson, another beautiful drive. And just like that, Akron takes a 14-10 lead. So Ohio has to respond. Nathan Rourke hands to Ross. Ross gets blown up. A 0-yard rush right there. And now we're going to go to 3rd and 5 on that drive. Nathan Rourke going to drop back, scans the field, and he is taken down. Rourke gets sacked right there, and they are forced to bring out Michael Farkas to punt this one away. We got to show it because Farkas rarely sees the field, but there's a punt. Williams going to return, make it out to the 40-yard line, a 11-yard return for Andre Williams. So Cato Nelson in this hot Akron offense return to the field. Nelson going to let it go, and he's going to find his man Stewart down the sideline, touchdown. A 60-yard touchdown for Nate Stewart. Cato Nelson has been spectacular so far today, and Akron takes a 21-10 lead. This Ohio defense on its heels pretty much the whole game, following a bad loss to Northern Illinois as well. Julian Ross on the next drive, though, picks up 16. If Ohio's going to have to get back in this game, it's not going to be from going 3 and out. So Nathan Rourke scanning the field, and he's going to go down. A 12-yard loss. Sean Featherstone with the sack. Taking a look at this one again, bringing Rourke down. So now 2nd and 22, Nathan Rourke's going to drop back. He's going to throw, finds Cam Odom, a 14-yard reception, but not good for the first down after that huge sack. So now 3rd and 7, Rourke scans the field and finds Isaiah Cox. How did he catch that? A 7-yard reception for him. He has 2 catches on the day now. Ray Nathan Rourke going to roll out, going to find Julian Ross on the wheel route, and he's going to pass the Akron 30-yard line, a 19-yard reception for Ross. Been such an important back for this team. About 4 minutes left in the half here. Nathan Rourke, 5 wide, rolling out to his right. He can't get the pass off, and he goes down. Another sack, that one by John Lako for Akron. So now 3rd and 4. Rourke going to drop back. He rolls out to the left, can't find anyone open, but he's going to keep it himself and make it out of bounds. He fumbles the football, but already out of bounds after an 8-yard rush. Now, Joe Mishler in the game after that hit on Nathan Rourke out of bounds, and Joe Mishler is going to pick up 10. Now, Julian Ross in the backfield, and he's going to get stuffed after a 2-yard rush. Now, 3rd and goal, Mishler going to keep, and he makes his way into the end zone. a 21-16 lead for AKRON still, but Ohio now only down by 4 points with 2:35 left to play until halftime. Kato Nelson hands off to Deltron Sands, and he gets stuffed, only gains about 2 on that play. Now 2 minutes left to go in the half, as I said before, but now we're really there. Kato Nelson dropping back. He's going to throw, finds Andre Williams again, and he's going to pick up about 10 right there. I formation again. Akron's got to hurry a bit, though, and they're going to throw out of that formation and going to find Darryl Long at the 50-yard line. Maybe makes it slightly into Ohio territory. Clock is ticking for Akron. Kato Nelson going to drop back, and he's going to have to throw that one away as Jared Dorsa's right in his face. That's his first incompletion on the day. So now 3rd and 10 for the Zips. Kato Nelson dropping back. He scans the field. He tries to get away. He breaks a tackle, almost intercepted by Ilias Motley, but is dropped. However, it is 4th and 10, so Akron will have to punt. So now 1 minute left. Nathan Rourke does return to the game after being knocked out for a few plays. He's going to throw down the field and find a wide open Cam Odom. But if he hit him more in stride, that was a touchdown. The next play, though, finds Cam Odom again wide open. And that one is a touchdown. Cameron Odom, 2 great plays on that drive. And Ohio takes an immediate lead on Akron, 24-21 with 30 seconds to play in the half. So 30 seconds left. Kato Nelson dropping back. He's going to throw. They want to score. Darryl Long out to the 50-yard line, to the 40, and he gets pushed out of bound. 27 seconds to go in the half. Akron nearing field goal range now. 22 seconds left. Waiting for the snap. Kato Nelson drops back. Hands off to Deltron Sands, and he loses yards as Akron calls a timeout right there. 20 seconds left. 3rd and 13. Kato Nelson going to drop back. He looks, and Andre Williams drops the pass. So Ohio will get the ball back with 17 left to go. Akron tries a really long field goal. We'll see if he can get that. That kick is up and not even close. So now Ohio gets the ball with great field position with 13 seconds left to play. Cam Odom rolls out to the right. He looks. He's going to throw. No, he's going to keep it. And he will have 6 seconds left. Now a handoff quickly to Julian Ross. He gets down, and Ohio will call a timeout. Not quite in field goal range, though. They're going to try the Hail Mary. It's going to throw. Caught by Foster. And a flag is down. And it is on the Zips. A face mask against Akron. Jeffrey Lubin can't have that happen. So now Ohio is in field goal range of Louis Zervos. That one is going to be up and good. So Ohio takes a 6-point lead going into halftime. Don't worry, no stoppage here. We're going straight into the second half. So the third quarter, Akron starts with the ball. They're going to throw, and Darryl Long's going to drop the ball. Couple drops plaguing Akron so far today. Gotta get that cleaned up if they want to hang in there with this Ohio offense. Now Kato Nelson gonna drop back. He's gonna throw, finds a wide open Darryl Long on this play for about 30, 28 to be specific. Now Kato Nelson gonna drop back again, finds Andre Williams, and he will get a 13-yard reception. Driving down the field with ease so far, Kato Nelson and the Zips are. Kato Nelson going to drop back again here. Finds Darryl Long. Always open today. Stiff arms Motley. And he's going to go out of bounds. 1st and goal now. Deltron Sands going to keep. And he's going to be tackled at about the 1-yard line. So at the 1. 2nd and goal. Pitch to Sands. Good blocking by Akron. And there goes Deltron Sands into the end zone for a Zips touchdown. And Akron takes the lead with the extra point. So responding for OU. That's what they've been doing all day. Julian Ross going to keep up the gut, and that's going to be an 8-yard gain. And they say, let's do it again. Right to Julian Ross again, and he gets even more. That's 16 yards right there on that play. So now 2nd and 10, 5 minutes left in the third quarter. Catch by O'Shawn Allison, and the Bobbies driving down the field. Third and six now for Ohio. Nathan Rourke rolling out to his left. Does he have any room? No. Throws to DL Knock, luckily, but will only be a one-yard reception. So Louis Zervos will take the field goal, and that is no good. He misses on that play. So now, gonna throw. Javon Hagan drops an interception on Cato Nelson. That's the second dropped interception by Ohio today after the missed field goal. Deltron Sands loses one on that play. Excuse me. Finding myself after that missed field goal. Cato Nelson gonna throw over the field and finds Jeremiah Knight. And Knight picks up 33 on that play. Chunk plays every day for the Zips. Now, Nelson looking, has plenty of time, rolling out to his left and going to be taken down after an 8-yard rush. Ohio and AKRON both have very similar offenses as I'm seeing so far as he gets taken down right there. And the field goal unit will come out again for the Zips, but a very long field goal. And this one has no chance of making it. Falls right between the I and the P in the Zips logo on the field. And now Ross will pick up 7 on the next Ohio drive, going into it right away. A minute and a half about left in this quarter. Julian Ross going to take that one for 15 yards. He has been ridiculous today. Over 124 yards rushing, averaging about 7 a carry. Nathan Rourke going to scramble. He's going to throw. What composure by Rourke, and finds Cam Odom over the middle of the field. That puts him over 250 passing yards. And what a play for the senior for Ohio. And Nathan Rourke going to keep again, and he's going to pick up 12 yards. That's why he is so dangerous. Now, first and goal. Nathan Rourke keeps into the end zone, and Ohio takes the lead right there. A 5-point lead. They're going to go for 2 now. Ross in the backfield. Handoff to him, and he gets stuffed behind the line of scrimmage. So it will be a 5-point game as AKRON gets the ball back. So 25 seconds left to go in the quarter. Cato Nelson going to drop back. He scans the field. He's going to throw. Finds Deltron Sands. Sands going to gain 1 on that play. Lucky he didn't lose any yards. So the quarter comes to an end about here. Nelson going to drop back. He's going to scramble. He's going to be taken down. And that'll do it here going into the fourth quarter in AKRON, Ohio. Ohio leads by 5 going into the fourth. This one is another classic, folks. Never can seem to blow out an opponent, but every game is interesting this way at least. Cato Nelson going to drop back. He rushes forward. He gets hit pretty hard, but picks up the first down. Zips mascot loves it. So 7:40 left to go in the game. Cato Nelson going to throw. And dropped by Stewart on that one. These drops need to be cleaned up for AKRON in the coming weeks. Can't do anything about them right now. As Cato Nelson drops back again and going to throw this one right out of bounds. No one had a chance to catch that one. So now 3rd and 10 for AKRON. Cato Nelson going to drop back. Finds Deltron Sands on the screen. Sands gets the first down and more. Good blocking down the field for AKRON. And Javon Hagan, only player probably fast enough to catch Deltron Sands, catches him around the 25-yard line, and AKRON goes over 300 passing yards today because of it. So Cato Nelson going to drop back again, and he gets sacked right there. What a play by Ohio. And now Cato Nelson going to drop back again, and he goes down again. Another sack. It's 3rd and 21. Dylan Connor there on the sack after one by Jared Dorsa. Now Nelson going to throw. Gets that one away quickly. Doesn't get sacked, but Andre Williams far from a first down. So here comes the field goal unit again. This one must seem easy to the AKRON kicker from where he's been kicking from. And sure enough, it is. AKRON comes within 2. Next Ohio drive. Julian Ross going to keep. He has some room. Picks up the first down and a little more. That's a 15-yard rush for Ross. He's been unstoppable today. Nathan Rourke going to drop back again. He's going to throw, and that's incomplete. And that was on 3rd down. So 4th down, Ohio's going to have to punt it back to AKRON. Cato Nelson on the next drive throws, finds Andre Williams. He gets 9 on that play after a fun little spin move after getting hit. Now, Cato Nelson hands off to Deltron Sands. Sands has room. Picks up 10 on that play. Pretty good rush by him. It's first and 10. Now Nelson going to throw. And Andre Williams loses a yard there. Ohio's done a pretty decent job containing those routes very short. But it's going deep they've had a problem with. There goes Long. Darryl Long gets 10 on that play. It'll be third and 1 for the Zips. Cato Nelson going to keep it. Jared Dorsa completely whiffs on the tackle. And that will be the first down and more for AKRON. So it's 2nd and 6 for the Zips now. Deltron Singh is going to break a tackle. He's going to get down the field down to the 10-yard line. And AKRON is driving. 3 minutes left in the game. And AKRON's in field goal range to take the lead. Hand off to Lee now. Sands needs a break every now and then. And Brandon Lee is going to lose 2 on that play right there. 1:58 to go. And Deltron Sands gets tackled short. And on 4th and 4, AKRON's going to kick the field goal with just under 2 minutes to play. The field goal for the Zips is up, and it is good. So Ohio needs to get 2 points, a field goal on this drive, 3 points specifically, to take this lead at least. So 1:52 to go. Isaiah Cox, there's a hole for him on the return, up to the 50, 45-yard line, and that is the perfect start. Only need about 15 yards to be in Zervos' comfortable field goal range, and there's a handoff to Ross, and he picks up about half of it right there. So 1:22 to play, handoff to Julian Ross again. He picks up the first down. Ohio able to milk some clock right here. So 1st and 10, handoff to Ross again. They're doing a better job containing Ross, but they need to at this point. They need to sell out to stop him. 155 yards rushing for him today. Rourke's going to drop back. The offensive lineman lets rushers through and completes the screen to Ross for 10 yards. And that's another Bobcat first down, 43 yards receiving for Ross today. Now O'Shawn Allison, the backup, going to get a carry. Ross probably extremely tired. Now, 2nd and 4, Nathan Rourke going to get hit. Lucky he held on to the football there. 20 seconds left, first down. And they are going to get this lined up, not take any more chances for Louis Zervos. And here comes the offense back on the field. And they're just going to let this clock tick. They're not going to take a shot. They're going to come on and try and win the game right here with this kick. Louis Zervos, always reliable, missed one earlier in the game today. But he won't miss this one. Ohio gets it done against AKRON, and they improve to 4-1 on the year. Great win by the Bobcats. Julian Ross, amazing. You know who else was amazing? Our player of the game today, Nathan Rourke. He did it on the ground. He did it in the air. Really good stuff from him. Taking a look at his stat line, he had 2 touchdowns in total. So big win for Ohio right here. So we're going to take a little look here at recruiting real quick. And we get Brian Smith committing to the team after that big win. He said, you know what? That is a team I want to play with. So OU gets Brian Smith. And we're going to take a look at the scores around the nation. I'll let you guys view these scores on your own. I'll just wrap up the video. If you enjoyed it, thank you guys so much for watching. If you liked the video, make sure you press that like button. If you didn't like it, make sure you tell me below. If you really liked it, maybe go ahead and hit that subscribe button. We're like 4 subs away now from 100 as the day I'm recording this. So if you guys enjoyed the video, thank you guys so much for watching. I have been Mo Sports Network, and I will see you guys next time. So I'll leave the last minute or so for you guys to look at the scores, but that's going to be it for me. So see you guys later. Peace out.